Hello students, let's continue with mathematics 2, chapter number 1, partition values. And I am taking sum number 4 of exercise 1.1. Whichever question I have not done in the class, you all have to do it as a homework. Okay, so let's begin sum number 4. From the following data of daily expenditure of families in rupees, compute the expenditure below which 75% of the families include their expenditure. Below which 75%, we have seen in the first lecture, the basic lecture, what we have done. I told you that the data is divided into four parts. Char part mein divide hota hai. Okay. The first part is 25%, 25%, 25%, 25%. See, the data is divided into four parts. 25, 25, 25, 25. Total is 100. So, 25, 25, 25, 25, hi char part rahenge. So, when we talk about 75%, so when it is 50% data, matlab 25, 25 is 50, then here the value is called as median, or it is called as quartile 2. This is called as quartile 1. This is called as quartile 3. So, when we talk about 75% data is called as quartile 3. 75% data. So quartile 3. Matlab, in this question, they have not directly told us to find the value of quartile 3, but it is understood that below 75%, that means you are supposed to find what? You are supposed to find quartile 3. Okay. So let's begin. The first column is daily expenditure in rupees, that is X column. The second column is number of families, that is frequency. The third column you have to prepare is called as a cumulative frequency. Cumulative frequency, that also a less than time. Which frequency? Cumulative frequency less than time. Matlab, upar se add karte karte niche aana hai. You all have studied in your school level. But ek baar fir se dekh lena. How to prepare a cumulative frequency column? This number will remain the same. 16 plus 19 is 35. 35 plus 24 is 59. 59 plus 28 is 87. 87 plus 13 is 100. Hope you understand. Once again, 16 will remain as it is. 16 plus 19 is 35. 35 plus 24 is 59. 59 plus 28 is 79, 87. 87 plus 13 is 100. So the value of n is equal to 100. Okay. Now, what is the formula of quartile 3? Humne dekha hai formula last lecture mein. 3 to 3. N plus 1 divide by 4 th term. Koi teacher bolenge ke because this is a round figure, then you have to write n divided by 4 directly. But in the textbook they have given n plus 1 divided by 4. So we are taking n plus 1 divided by 4. So 3 n is 100 plus 1 divided by 4 th observation or term, whatever. So 3 into 101 upon 4. Observation. Okay, we'll write observation. So 101 upon 4 will be 3 into 101 divided by 4. 4 2's are is 8. 2 1. 4 5's are is 20. Point. 4 2's are is 8. 4 5's are is 20. So you have to multiply. 3 into 25.25. 3 5 is 15, 3 to the 6, 7, 3 5 is 15, 3 to the 6, 7, 75.75 is the answer. TH observation, 75.75, where to check? You have to check in CF column, Idhar baithega? Nahin. Idhar baithega? Nahin. Idhar baithega? Nahin. Idhar baithega? Haan. That means your quartile 3 is 650. Your quartile 3 is 650. But this is not the final answer. Because in the question they have asked us to find the families where 75% of the data. That is why you have to write in words, you have to write the sentence, and then you get the answer as 650 rupees. Okay, this is sum number 5. In sum number 5, number of e-transactions per day are given and number of days are given. We are supposed to find all the three quartiles, quartile 1, quartile 2, quartile 3. So let's begin. The first column is once again X, the second column is F. Now you have to prepare CF column. CF means cumulative frequency less than time. So first number will remain the same, 10. 10 plus 35 is 45. 45 plus 45 is 90. Plus 95 is 185. 185 plus 64 is 189. 189 plus 60 is 199. 209, 219, 229, 239, 249. 249 plus 32, this is 32. 249 plus 32 is 251. 281. 281 plus 10 is 291. 291 plus 9 is 300. So the value of n is equal to 300. Any props? No props. Easy yahan tak? Clear hai? You have to prepare CF column, then use the formula, then get the answer. So first formula I'll use, that is of quartile 1, that is 1 n plus 1 divided by 4 th term. So I'll get n, the value of n is 300. 300 plus 1 divided by 4 th term, that will be 301 upon 4th term or 4th observation, whatever is given in the book. So 300 divided by 4 is 21. So 300 divided by 4 will be 4, 7 is 28, bachega 21, 4, 5 is 20. Bachega 104, 2 is 8, 4, 5 is 25. 75.25th observation. So what is the value of Q1? 75.25 ka batega. Isme 10 mein nahi, 45 mein nahi, 90 mein yes. So your answer of quartile 1 is 2. So 2 transactions per day. You have to write 2 transactions per day. Hope you understand. हाँ मतलब sentence में answer लिखना इतना याद है. Okay, so go for the quartile 2 is 2 n plus 1 divided by 4th term, that is 2, n is 300 plus 1 divided by 4th term or observation, whatever. So I'll get, पहले से ये मिल गया ना 75.25. So 2 into 75.25 is 150.5. observation. So 150.5 कहाँ बैठेगा? Q2. 150.5. 90 में नहीं, इसमें yes. So your Q2 is 3 transactions per day. Okay. Next is Q3. Q3 is 3 n plus 1 divided by 4th observation. So I'll get 3 into 300 plus 1 divided by 4th observation. So it will be 3 into 75.25. 3 5s are 15, 5 1. 3 2s are 6, 7. 3 5s are 15, 5 1. 3 7, 21, 22. So 225.75th observation. So what is 225.75? Kahan pe baithega? Isme, yes. So your quartile 3 is 4 transactions per day. So you have got the answer as 4. So quartile 1, 2, quartile 3, sorry, 2 is 3 and quartile 3 is 4. Okay. This is the last question of today's video. Here in this question, we are supposed to find only the value of quartile 2. See, this is a table where class intervals are given. Class intervals are given. That means this is a grouped frequency distribution table. इसके पहले वाले सम में भी ग्रुप था, ग्रुप नहीं था, उसको discrete frequency distribution table बोलते हैं. Discrete, where there are only two columns of X and F. But this is class interval and frequency, so it is called as a grouped frequency distribution. And that too, it is in a continuous form. Continuous form में, continuous form में. Hope you understand. We are supposed to find the value of quartile 2. First column, always you have to prepare CF. First number will remain the same, 4. 4 plus 6 is 10. 10 plus 25 is 35. 35 plus 57 is 92. 92 plus 64 is 156. 156 plus 30 is 186. Plus 8 is 194. Plus 6 is 200. So I got the value of n as 200. Hope this is clear. Is it clear? Yahan tak samajh mein aa gaya? Clear. Now, the next thing you are supposed to do is formula. Quartile 2 is nothing but 2n upon 4. 2n upon 4. Now here, when there is a group frequency distribution, here the formula is not n plus 1 upon 4. Here directly it is given n upon 4. Samajh mein aa raha hai na? See, many teachers will say that it depends on this number also. But in the textbook, if they are giving n upon 4, so we will solve by n upon 4, we will get the answer. So 2 into 200 upon 4, your answer will be 100. 100, na? 2 1s are, 2 2s are, 2 1s are, 2 100s are. So answer is 100. 100 kaha baithta hai? 4 mein nahi. 10 mein nahi. 35 mein nahi. 92 mein nahi. 156 mein yes. तो 156 को ऐसा एरो कर देना है एंड स्टार्ट विद दिस क्लास. ये क्लास से एक सांप बनाना है. फिर से एक बार 156 को एरो एंड देन यहां से एक सांप बनाना है. दिस इज द सेम कैलकुलेशन व्हाट यू हैड डन इन 10th स्टैंडर्ड फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग मीडियन बिकॉज क्वार्टाइल 2 इज नथिंग बट मीडियन. अभी क्वार्टाइल 2 पूछा है, क्वार्टाइल 1 पूछा. क्वार्टाइल 1 पूछता तो 1 एन अपॉन 4 लिखता. सेम थिंग सांप बनाता. क्वार्टाइल 3 पूछता तो 3 एन अपॉन 4 लिखता. सेम थिंग सांप बनाता. समझ में आ रहा है ना? सो क्वार्टाइल 2 पूछा, क्वार्टाइल 1 पूछा है, क्वार्टाइल 3 पूछा, द आंसर विल रिमेन द सेम. समझ में आ रहा है? ओनली द फॉर्मूला विल चेंज, द लॉजिक ऑफ द स्नेक विल रिमेन द सेम. देखो ना, सांप का मुंह जो है ऊपर रहेगा, नीचे नहीं रहेगा, ऊपर रहेगा 90. सो आई विल राइट क्वार्टाइल 2 क्लास इज 165 टू 170. Your L is 165. Your F is, this is F column. So this is F, 64. And your CF is 92. So I write the formula of quartile 2. Same formula of median. L plus N upon 4, 2N upon 4, minus CF upon F into H. L, what is L? 165 plus 2n upon 4, answer is 2n upon 4, answer is 100 minus CF, CF is 92 upon F, F is 64 into H. H means what? H means height, class width, class difference. What is the difference between the class? 170 or 160, what difference kitna hai? 5. Kitna hai? 5. 5. You can write the formula as L2 minus L1 also. L2 minus L1, L2 minus L1. Upper limit minus lower limit. Upper limit minus lower limit. So you'll get 5. So I'll get 165 plus 8 upon 64 into 5. 8 ones are 8, 8 is a 165 plus 5 upon 8. That means 165 plus 5 upon 8. 8 divided by 5 karo. 8, 0. 8 6 is 48, 2 8 2 is 16, 8 5 is 40. So answer will be 165.625. Okay, so this is in centimeters, height in centimeters. So your answer will be in centimeters. So quartile 1 pucha, to ye wala formula hai. Agar quartile 2 pucha, to ye formula likhna hai. Agar quartile 1 pucha, to same likhna hai. Dekho na, same likhna hai. Quartile 1 is equal to L plus. सिर्फ क्या करना है इधर 2n upon 4 है ना, तो 1n upon 4 minus CF upon F into H. quartile 3 पूछा है तो 3, तो 3, 2 तो 2, 1 तो 1. अरे समझ में आ रहा है? means the steps will be same. clear है? next lecture में और चाहिए तो ऐसे sums कराऊंगा, but you all have to do it on your own first. पहले तुम लोग solve करो एंड देन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में मैं थोड़ा और आगे जाता हूं और थोड़े ऐसे सम सॉल्व करता हूं. ओके, बाय बाय.